concentration camp. I'd lost about a quarter of my weight. And at that point, although we were already getting prayer from many people, a wise friend came to me and said, "Lee, you have a lot of people praying for you, but God has given special people in the church gifts of healing, and you need to seek out people with gifts of healing to pray for you." And at that very same time, God began to orchestrate people into my life who had specific gifts of healing, Nigel being one of them. When Nigel came to Wheaton, Illinois that year, my friends literally carried me to see you, and we sat in a room for probably 2.5-3 hours. My husband and I, Nigel, a couple of people from the Order of St. Luke's, my good friend Carol, and Nigel took time with me that day. He asked a lot of questions about the state of my soul, the state of my marriage. He was looking for health in me. He was looking for spiritual maturity, I think. And he gave me a lot of really great advice. But I think the most important thing you did for me that day was that several times during the conversation, you laid your hands on me, and there was a clear electric current that flowed through your arm, into your hand, you know, pancreas sits up there, into my back. And you would ask me, what are the images, Lee? Where do you see God meeting you as I'm praying over you? It was a very powerful 3 hours. Now, you may not know this, Nigel, but about 2 days later, I was laying in bed super, super, super sick. And I felt the Holy Spirit come to me, and he came with a giant hand with a very long finger. And he reached into my side, and he told me, "Lee, I have destroyed the tumor." And he kind of lifted up like it was a dandelion on the end of his finger, and he just blew it away. And he told me, "What you need to do now is to love." He said, "Your pancreas is like a bruised and battered child. You need to love it and help it come back to life." From there, I went on and I finished the last 6 rounds of chemo. But the doctors thought that I would get better shortly after chemo, and that really didn't happen. In fact, there was one night right towards the end where the veil between this life and heaven came very, very close, and the angels came to me and said, they stood around my bed with huge, they were warrior angels, and they said, "She is not yours to take. She is not, it is not her time to pass over." It was probably 2.5 years. You know, Francis McNutt, who's also been a part of this story, says that healing rarely happens instantaneously. It's often slow and gradual. And that's what it was for me. I'm now 7 years past my initial diagnosis. There is no evidence of disease in either my pancreas or my liver,
wow,
which is just a miracle of God's healing for me. And there's been a new call in my life to minister healing to others because of this experience. It's taken me a little while to learn how to be a healing prayer minister. I think when you have been healed, people really seek you out as someone that they want to have pray for them. But love the story of Hezekiah and his healing. But you know, there's a little short story about Hezekiah that turns up in the book of Isaiah. And it's kind of Hezekiah saying, well, why me? You know, why did God, in all of his mysteries, why me? And the answer back to him is, the dead don't praise me. It's the living who sing my praises. It's the living who speak healing to other people. It's the living who bring this to life here and now. And I think for all of us, because I know there are many in this room who have been healed, we are the living, and we are the ones to sing his praise. We are not in the grave.
Praise God. Beautiful. Wow. Beautiful.